Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. If you're new here, hi, I'm Mitali and I'm a first year MBBS student. So today's video is going to be about what's on my iPad, and honestly my iPad is helpful to me for my studies, for my self-care, for my entertainment and a lot more. So without any further ado, let's quickly get into the video. While talking about my iPad, I have the 4th generation iPad Air with the 2nd generation Apple Pencil, and I also got this cover for my iPad with an inbuilt Bluetooth keyboard. Talking about the lock screen of my iPad, here I have this heart wallpaper which I really loved. I downloaded it from an app known as Aesthetic, and the home screen wallpaper I got it from Pinterest. I also like to have a few widgets on the home screen which are from the Forest app, from Spotify and some random other widgets. Talking about the screen, I like to keep most of the apps in different menus so that I don't spend much time in scrolling and finding the apps. The first menu is called Productivity, and the first app here is Concepts, which I use for note taking mostly. It is a free app and I started my note taking with this app itself. The second app is Flexil. This is also used for note taking, and this is also again a free app. I use its free version. The third app is OneNote. This is also a free note taking app, and I do a lot of my note taking on this app. The next app is called Pages. Now, Pages is basically used to create Word documents, and it can be used for different sorts of college assignments and making some good documents. The next app is Notes from Apple itself, which I mostly use to make my to-do lists. The next app is Anatomy Learning. Now this app is really helpful to me, at least for visualizing all the muscles, their attachments and the bones which are present in the human body, especially in these COVID times when we cannot go to the dissection hall. Next we have the Good Notes app, which is a paid app, but it is my most used app on the iPad. I use it for digital note taking and for also reading all my ebooks, and I absolutely love it. Next we have this Sticky Notes app, which helps me create these digital sticky notes which help me in quicker learning. Next we have MS Word, which I again use for making documents. The next menu is for Photos and Videos, which has YouTube, Instagram, Pinterest, which I use for taking inspiration for art and fashion, etc. Then we have Pigment, which is an art app basically. It is an adult coloring app which you can use if you are a person who likes coloring as a therapy. I use it sometimes when I'm free. I use the free version of this app. I don't have the paid version of it. Next we have Aesthetic app, from where I download my wallpapers, then Telegram and YouTube Studio. Next menu is Productivity again, where I have these four upper apps called Planty, Flipped, Study Bunny and Forest, which I use for concentration during my studies. Next we have these apps, two apps called MindNote and XMind, which I used for making mind maps. They have different, you know, layouts in which you can make different sorts of mind maps, and I think this is really useful. I've not used these apps a lot, but I'm looking forward to use them really soon. Next I have WordPress, where I vlog, Medium, where I read, and Canva, where I make my Instagram stories. These are all the editing apps that I use. Next we have Music, which has Spotify and Gaana. Next we have Entertainment, where I use these three apps to watch movies and other stand-up videos. Next, I have Google Docs and Google Sheets, which I use for creating various assignment trackers and my timetables and various other documents. Next, I have Drive, where I get different PDFs of different ebooks and notes and slides and all such sorts of things, mostly study related. Next, I have Gmail, where I check my mails. Next is this app called Todo, which is from Microsoft, and this is really a very good app. You can write all the tasks that you have to do in your day and you can tick them off when they are done. Next, we have this shopping menu, where I have all the apps that I use for my online shopping. Next, I have this app known as Drink Water, which gives me a reminder every 45 minutes to drink water, and a few more self-care apps here like Daleo and a few virtual journal apps which I really really love. Next, I have this WhatsApp Messenger, which I sometimes have to use if I have to download certain documents from my WhatsApp, and this is all that I have on my iPad. If you like this video, do not forget to give it a thumbs up. Comment down below if you have any video suggestions or feedback for me, and do share this video and subscribe to the channel. I will see you again very, very soon. Till then, stay safe, take care, bye-bye.